It's too bad that wasn't the real Eifried. But I'm glad everyone on the ship is feeling better.
Yeah. Though it sounds like they never want to touch that Salatoma stuff ever again.
What about Eleanor?
She took it too. And her face went all... Wah!
I don't mean how she looked. I mean how she actually feels.
Oh. Well, she looks like she feels better too.
Good.
You're worried about her, aren't you, Velvet?
No, it's nothing like that.
Let me tell you something, kiddo. When young maidens ripen, they have trouble expressing their feelings.
So Velvet's... ripen?
Mogilu! Quit giving Loffy set confusing thoughts!
No trouble expressing those feelings, I see.
The Abbey is supposed to exist to bring peace and order to the world. Everything the Abbey does, everything Lord Melchior and Shepherd Artorias do, it ought to be rooted in that mission. And yet, something just doesn't feel right here.
You are dismissed. That knowledge is not for you.
Something wrong?
Whoa! Easy there. Just asking.
Sorry. I was just deep in thought. Is there something you need from me?
Nah. Just heard a bunch of sighs and wondered if you were feeling sick or anything.
No, I drank my Salatoma juice.
Ah. Tasted like crap, didn't it?
It wasn't that bad.
Hey.
What?
Are you afraid of demons?
No, I am not. It's more like I despise them. 10 years ago, a group of them attacked my village. They destroyed everything. And everyone.
Including your family?
Yes. The only family I had at that point was my mother. And in all the chaos, she... All I have left of her is this hand mirror she gave me. I didn't want anyone else to have to feel the way I did. And so I became an exorcist in order to destroy demons. So you can keep your pity.
Gotcha. I will then.
That's called a pangyon, a type of bird native to this area.
Pangyon.
Their meat is succulent and tender, and makes a lovely stew.
Wow, what's it taste like?
You'd eat that poor thing? Savage.
You're one to talk, demon. It was one of my mother's specialties.
All right, enough of the chit-chat. Mogilu, what's this grimoire friend of yours like?
Well, how do I put it? Oh. You know, like that.
Like what?
Well, to put it in a way those of meager imagination can understand... Grim's got a sort of listless, aristocratic air about her. A noblewoman in her twilight, you could say. Huh. So you mean, like, a woman, but different from Velvet and Eleanor.
You're not wrong there. Tell you what, just keep an eye out for a grown woman.
Grown woman. Okay, I got it.
Well, since we got her name, we could start by asking around.
Exactly. Now you're talking. What's up, kiddo?
Moggy Lou, you're a grown woman yourself. So why is it you have trouble clearly expressing your real feelings?
Good question. Put simply, a long time ago, mine broke. Bagow! Chapoom! Bye-bye!
Your feelings broke?
Come on. Let's question the townsfolk.
So how do you like our island? Nice and laid back, right?
It's quite a bit different from Logris.
This place was even more relaxed before the opening. But recently, a lot of our young folk have gone starry-eyed about the city and left us in the lurch.
It's still better than it was when the demons first started showing up. We have the Abbey to thank for that. And because people are traveling more now, the need for ships has skyrocketed. Our lumber industry is booming.
In other words, when the money started flowing, people let it go to their heads?
That and those exorcists and soldiers from the bigger cities, they really seemed sophisticated. People from the other islands wear different clothes and have things we don't, you know?
Getting worked up and worked over by what's trendy. Is that foolishness not the very definition of youth?
If this keeps up, our island's traditions will fade away. That's what worries me.
I understand how you feel, but you have to give young people the freedom to be themselves.
Come, sinner, and repent your wicked deeds.
Repent? Are you talking to me?
Yes. When I look at your vestments around your chest, your hips, I can tell your sins are many and deep.
Say that again. Exactly what were you staring at?
Well, mankind is rife with sin, and I am no different. You must acknowledge your misdeeds and confess them to the great Empyreans. By confronting your sinful urges, you will be empowered to resist them.
Is that so? You're saying I just need to confess all the bad things I've done?
Yes. Confess your darkest sins, my child, assured that none is beyond the forgiveness of the Empyreans.
Empyreans, hear my confession. When I was in prison, I instigated a riot and used it to break myself out.
Huh?
Then I set fire to some warehouses in town and stole a ship to make my getaway. Then I teamed up with some pirates to destroy a military fortress. I killed anyone who got in my way.
What?
What do you think, Father? Will the Empyreans forgive me?
I think you should turn yourself into the Abbey and let them help you repent.
That's convenient. I'm already planning on going to the Abbey. You see, I'm going to kill their boss, Artorius.
I need an exorcist over here! Quick! Somebody! Anybody!
That's about how I figured it'd go.
Come, sinner!
Are you talking to-
I am. You look so deeply, now confess!
Oh, how long have I waited to bear my soul to someone! But I've always lacked the courage. Praise be to the Empyreans who have bestowed upon me this chance today!
Ah, your devotion to the Empyreans is most...
No! It is you who has captured my devotion, my darling! There's no one else I want but you!
What? Me? But my life is in service to the Empyreans.
Hush! I want you to look at me the way I look at you. Hold me, darling! Smother me in your embrace!
I don't...
Those were the kind of lines I read in a romance novel. It wasn't even that exciting a book. I wasted so many hours with that piece of trash. Please, forgive me for not putting myself to better use.
Ah! Lying! To a priest! How could you?
Oh, no. I meant to confess my sins, but instead my confession was another sin! Forgive me, Father, I've transgressed once more.
I don't want to forgive you! Come, sinner, and repent your wicked deeds.
Who?
Me? I don't think I've done much that needs repenting.
No, my son. You must be mistaken. For I can tell just from how you dress that a great many sins weigh heavily upon your heart. But it's not too late for you yet. You must confess your sins and repent.
Yeah, I hear you, but I really can't think of anything.
Have you ever wielded violence?
No. All I wield are my swords.
Well, have you hurt anybody with your swords?
Yeah, but I haven't been able to land a killing blow yet. I've still got a long way to go. But the next time, I'll kill him.
No, you have it all wrong. You must repent for how you've used your swords.
Oh, I get it. I need to improve my cutting technique, right?
That's not what I meant either.
Ah, then what do you mean? It's a priest's job to guide the layman, right? You'll have to start speaking more clearly if you want anyone to trust your advice. Get your act together, man.
Yes, I'll reflect upon the error of my ways. Wait, what?
It's become common practice to use Southgan lumber for shipbuilding, but there's a reason. Our trees really are the best for it.
Natan trees only grow in Southgand. Their wood is light, tough, and doesn't rot. Perfect for shipbuilding.
You know your stuff. Long ago, before people knew how to build seafaring vessels, Midgan and Southgan were separate countries. Then our ancestors fashioned rafts out of Natan logs and floated all the way to Midgand. A Midgan craftsman, amazed to see a humble raft cross the open sea, returned with our ancestors here to Southgand.
He had used the natant logs to build a large, sturdy ship.
Thanks to him, commerce took off between Midgan and Southgand, and the age of exploration began. The excitement of a new age had everyone floating on air, but within mere decades, Midgan declared war on Southgand.
Ironically enough, it was ships made from trees from their islands that enemies used to invade them.
The fighting continued for a long time, but in the end, Midgand emerged the victor. Our islands were occupied. As hard as things were, our ancestors still liked to joke about it. They'd say, Age of Exploration, more like Age of Exploitation.
When things were that bad, they could still joke about it?
Southganders have always been a cheerful bunch. We tend to look for the silver lining in every cloud. It may not seem like it these days, but Southgand used to be a place where the laughter would never cease. Some people even used to call it Shenanigand.
Shenanigand? This must have been a really fun place.
Still no leads on that grimoire, lady.
Mogulo, when did you get that letter from her you mentioned?
Hard to say. It must have been last year? A decade ago?
Take this seriously, or I'll feed you to the sharks.
Oh, what? what? I think I'd at least rate a kraken.
Keep this up and I swear I'll eat. It's them.
The final preparations are complete. Once you've assumed your new post, everyone will act on your command.
Thank you, sister. But to be honest, I worry that these shoes I'm filling might just be a bit too big for me.
You need not worry. You possess a special strength and quality that others lack. Shepherd Artorias has high hopes for your deployment to Palamedes. Fear not. Just be yourself and you'll do fine. Believe you're a leader, and you will be.
Yes. I'll try to make you proud, sister.
They're sending him to Palamedes? Is that the name of a facility on this island?
I had better get going.
Safe travels.
Oh, one more thing. Be careful around the demon in Haria. It's stronger than it looks. We've even had some casualties.
Understood.
Also, if you must drink the water, remember to boil it.
Sister...
I know, I worry too much. But I just can't help myself.
So, there's a demon in Haria. Sounds like it's a pretty feisty one, too.
If so, it may prove useful.
Still, what magical timing for Oscar to show up here at the very same hour we do!
I understand your suspicion of me, but have you any proof?
None, it's true. But as an exorcist, you're certainly sympathetic to the Abbey's cause.
And soon you may wish we were sympathetic.
Eleanor hasn't been snitching on us. I'm sure of it.
And how would you know? Are you watching her even when she's taking a bath?
Huh? No, I don't. I always stay outside when she's taking a bath. And...
Then isn't it possible she's communicating with the Abbey in secret while you're not there?
You pledged to obey me until the day you die, correct?
Yes, that I did.
Remember, when you two trade blows, only the Abbey wins.
One less demon, one less traitor for them to worry about.
While we're standing around here arguing, that demon could be attacking Grimoire!
It's true. Let's find some more people to question around town. So what's it really like?
Huh?
The connection between Moloch and Vessel. Do you share, like, thoughts and feelings?
Sort of. When I'm dwelling inside Eleanor, I can see what she sees and hear what she hears. But I can't read her thoughts or her emotions. Sitting in a box doesn't teach you how the box feels.
I see. In that case... I want to give her as little time alone as possible.
I don't want to bathe with her, alright?
I know. You're a boy and all. For her baths, we can send Bienfu. No, that's a bad idea. It'll have to be Mogulu. Or myself.
Phew!
What sort of boundaries have you and Eleanor drawn? How do you sleep?
We talk before bed sometimes. But it's not like I'm sleeping by her side or anything. It's easier for me to tell when she wakes up if I'm dwelling inside her.
Does she ever get out of bed at night?
Not in my experience. And she sleeps so peacefully.
Huh?
When she's around you guys, she always looks so stern. But when she's sleeping, her expression is softer, you could say. She lets her hair down, too. And I think it's kind of prettier that way.
Huh. So that's what he likes. Well, keep an eye on her, but...
But?
Watch out for the older girls.
Huh? Teresa and Oscar sure seem close.
I've known them since I was an initiate, but I've never seen them quarrel, not even once.
Did you ever fight with your brother, Velvet?
Yeah, I guess I did. Sometimes I'd chew him out, and he'd sulk and stop talking to me, but I found that adorable too.
You did?
No matter how much he dug in his heels, or tried to talk like he was in charge, after a while he'd be right there trailing along behind me.
Like a little puppy dog.
Puppies are a lot more obedient. I always had to keep an eye on him. Little brothers are odd creatures.
Rokuro's a little brother. Is he adorable too?
Huh? I don't think a little brother who's out to kill you is in any way adorable.
But Shigure seemed like he was having fun.
Sometimes you just don't make sense.
Huh? I don't know.
Little brothers.
Do you have any siblings?
I'm an only child.
Well then, that's perfect. You pretend the boy is your little brother.
Huh?
That's a bit extreme, but actually, when I'm talking with Lafayette, sometimes I think, this is what having a brother must feel like.
I could be Eleanor's brother.
Don't take any of this nonsense seriously, Lafayette. Malakim are just tools to exorcists. She can never think of you as her brother.
Oh, yeah.
You're wrong. I've changed how I view Malakim. I know that's true because I can think of him as a brother.
Right.
She's all talk. Don't believe her.
It seems to me like you're the one who's treating him as a tool, by forcing your own opinions upon him.
Ooh, two sisters struggling for the affections of their brother. Eeny, teeny, candlestick, which one will the Muppet pick?
How about an older brother instead?